next question that we got is about the hip hinge and rowing. When it comes to rowing, do not be shocked if you've heard the 11 to 1 o'clock. And if you haven't, check out my other videos. And I talk about it, and so do a lot of other people. But when you're going back and forth, it does not surprise me that some people struggle with this. And I say that from the physical therapy perspective. I actually spend sessions teaching some people this movement. It is not uncommon, so please know that. It's a movement that if we haven't really been doing, then it feels foreign. Now there's ways that we can actually train it, but I'm gonna kind of just show you what it looks like, not on the rowing machine first. And this is kind of how I teach it to different clients. But if you are just stand up, and all you're gonna do is I want you to keep your stomach tight, so squeeze your stomach, not round your back. I want you to go like you're going to just lean at your hips and go and touch the floor. Now you might not touch the floor. I just want you to go as far as is comfortable, but I don't want your back to round, so it's not like you're reaching for the floor, so you can keep your hands to your side if you want to, but all you're gonna do is like a peeking duck type of movement. So all we're gonna do is bend at the hip and stand up. Bend at the hip and stand up. If you get numbness or tingling in your legs or anything, go ahead and put a slight bend in them. It doesn't need to be a straight knee. And you're just gonna go back and forth. This right here is the movement we are doing on the rowing machine. Now, this movement, if we were to add weight to it, is very similar, even without weight though, is very similar to a kettlebell swing. Now there's some variations in here, but it's very similar to a kettlebell swing, and it's very similar to a deadlift. So these are strength training workouts that really help to get that hip hinge movement trained into your movement, because we don't normally do this movement. There's not many times where I'm gonna bend down and not round my back. I'm gonna round my back so I can pick up that pencil. There's really not a lot of movements in our life where we actually do just that, unless you are doing it in a workout with, like, again, kettlebell swings, deadlifts, things like that. So don't feel bad about this being a difficult movement. It really is a hard movement for some people to learn and get their body motor training. The rowing movement really is mostly a learned movement. We have to learn it and teach ourselves to understand it. Very little of this movement is something that we are born with and learn over time, like walking and running. That's something that just starts to come natural to us. Even though some of us might like funny running, we all kind of know how to do it, right? We all have a way to do it. Rowing, it's completely new movement, completely learned. So don't feel bad if that hip hinge is something that you're struggling with. The way to start is, again, literally just stand and practice bobbing back and forth. And you don't need to go as far as I did. I'm trying to exaggerate it so you can see it. Even if you just start like this, that's all you're looking for. Just a back and forth movement. Now, when we're on the rowing machine, it's really small. It's 11 to 1. So definitely with the other things like the kettlebell and the deadlift and like me going to the exaggeration, that's a lot more than we're gonna do on the rowing machine. But it's okay to over get a broader range right now and then decrease it, because if you work in that broader range, it's actually easier for our body to understand it. We are going to, our body's gonna learn and understand that bigger movement, and then we can fine tune and finesse it. So that's where I would start. I hope that helps some of you guys out with that hip hinge movement, but it's definitely something that we need to practice and kind of work on, especially if it's not a movement that you're used to. So that's the hip hinge. Thanks for watching. I really hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I put new things out weekly so you can get new information. You can also join the Keep Rowing Longer Facebook group, where you can ask your questions and get your questions answered quickly. So if you're interested in that, I'd love to see you there. There's a link in that description below, and I hope to see you there and chat soon.